supply chain crunch is forcing big changes at Canada's largest distribution hub for fruits and vegetables. Larry Davidson's business imports fresh produce to sell to grocers.
We're flying product in more than we would have in the past. Obviously, it's more expensive, but we're also starting to bring product in a little bit earlier in some cases than we maybe would have.
Let's use the example of a shipment of blueberries coming to Canada from Peru. Pre-pandemic, the journey would take 10 to 12 days, but labor strikes in Peru and short-staffed ports can add 5 days. With West Coast ports jammed, many ships are diverting to the eastern seaboard, and the blueberries get caught in a traffic jam, adding another 5 days. U.S. labor shortages and COVID protocols are causing inspection delays, with goods left sitting in shipping containers adding another 2 to 3 days. And finally, the shortage of truck drivers can bring that journey to 25 days. But the shelf life of a refrigerated fresh blueberry is just a week or two. The imported produce that does make it to store shelves doesn't last as long once it reaches you.
Climate change is a supply chain issue.
This food economist says the increased frequency and severity of extreme weather events is taking a toll on the supply chain too. Dry conditions in the U.S. Southwest will increase prices. At this time of year, prices for American imports like strawberries, Brussels sprouts, and broccoli go up by about 10% because we can't produce them locally. Sticker shock will be bigger this year, though experts don't expect widespread shortages.
We have this large and complex and integrated food supply chain.
Solomon Zhu runs a small Toronto grocery shop. He says the impact behind the scenes favors larger rivals.
Sometimes when supply is very low, they tend to give the produce to higher stores, like the chain stores, instead of the small businesses. So then we have less stuff to sell.
And it's an added toll on household budgets that are already stretched.
Food price inflation has a particularly hard harder impact on lower income Canadians.
Anne Gaviola, Global News, Toronto.